Now at 5, a Target 12 investigators exclusive protecting pets as COVID restrictions are lifting. More people are boarding their pets as they begin to travel again. But Target 12 has discovered kennels in Rhode Island are rarely inspected for safety or cleanliness.
We've learned of more than 50 kennels. The state has issued only 3 violations in the last 2 years. One license was not renewed because conditions at the facility were so bad. Target 12 investigator Sarah Grinelli has the exclusive details.
The investigation that led to this kennel losing its license happened entirely by chance when the state veterinarian happened to be driving by and noticed the facility had moved.
These are photos taken at Doggy Styles in North Smithfield during an inspection by the Department of Environmental Management in August and November of 2019. The inspection found several violations, including this cage that was so small the dog couldn't fully stand up, and another cage that was filthy. You can see the dog's water dish is filled with urine. The DEM criminally charged the owner, John Frias, with 16 counts, including cruelty to animals and illegal practice of veterinary medicine. According to court documents reviewed by Target 12, the facility was never licensed to operate in North Smithfield and was never inspected until the state veterinarian noticed his facility had moved, prompting the inspection.
We always conduct an inspection when a new facility is going to open, and then we respond to complaints thereafter.
Eventually, more than 20 other animals were seized from Frias's property. He pleaded not guilty. His case is pending in Superior Court. A Target 12 review of DEM records found while kennels are inspected when they first open or when they receive a complaint, they rarely are once up and running. Along with the state, city and towns have the authority to inspect kennels and doggy daycare facilities. However, we called every municipality, and of those 19 that responded, only 6 towns say they inspect kennels once a year. State veterinarian Dr. Scott Marshall says his small team tries to inspect facilities as often as they can.
That's basically a limitation of the staffing that we have. You know, we would like to conduct inspections more often than that, but we've had to resort to having them, basically complaint-based.
Along with Frias's case, Target 12 found the state has issued 3 kennel violations in the past 2 years. In 2018, one kennel received a violation because inspectors found a group of dogs were left unsupervised, and DEM documents show a dog named Eli was attacked and later died. In 2019, another kennel was cited for having 25 dogs when they were allowed to only care for 9. The same year, another kennel received a violation when 3 puppies died after a dog was in labor for 22 hours, and inspectors say the owner failed to call a vet. Although the vast majority of kennels are a safe space for animals, Dr. Marshall says mandating annual inspections would provide more scrutiny on the facilities.
You know, putting in a regulation, I mean, it hasn't been a consideration, but, you know, I mean, if I think it's a viable solution to explore if, you know, if the need arose.
We reached out to Frias's lawyer and have not heard back. You can reach out to DEM or your town to see if your kennel has been inspected. New at 6, what you need to know about kennels and vaccine requirements for your dog if you're planning to board it this summer. With the Target 12 investigators, Sarah Grinelli, 12 News.
Now we continue our Target 12 investigators exclusive, protecting pets. At 5, we told you how rarely kennels across the state are inspected. And with more people planning to travel this summer, boarding family pets is once again in demand.
But new this hour, we're learning not all kennels follow the same guidelines to prevent your dog from getting sick. Target 12 investigator Sarah Grinelli is looking into what is and what isn't required to keep your pets safe.
The state requires every dog to have a rabies vaccine, but when it comes to other vaccines like the potentially deadly kennel cough, that's up to each city and town, and mostly at the discretion of the kennel.
It's a pup's paradise at A Dog's Life, Rhode Island, a doggy daycare in Bristol. Owner Matt Dame says he has strict vaccine requirements for any dog who comes to his at-home facility.
We do require all the routine vaccines, rabies, distemper, parvo combo. And then the 2 things that we require that the vet wouldn't typically do unless you told them they were going to be boarded or in daycare, or they board a televaccine, the kennel cough, and the fecal tests, where they test the stool sample for worms and parasites.
However, the state only mandates a rabies shot. Then it's up to each establishment or municipality if they want to require other vaccines.
People are lax and they do slack on things, and that just sets a bad example for pet owners in general.
If you're looking to board your pet, it's important to do your research on the facility. Check it out in person before booking. One way is to contact the Department of Environmental Management to see if there has been any past violations issued. And take your veterinarian's advice on what vaccine should be given to your dog.
The recommendation that, you know, any animal that's going to be boarded be vaccinated against Bordetella and other causes of respiratory disease. Yes, that's a recommendation, but certainly not a mandate.
Target 12 called every city and town in the state. Out of those who returned our call, we found Providence is the only city to have an ordinance that mandates a distemper vaccine, a viral disease that can be deadly. The state veterinarian, Dr. Scott Marshall, says another vaccine that could be mandated is parvovirus.
You know, I think the argument for parvo being mandated makes more sense because of more likely exposure and also the consequences of that disease. You know, young dogs that get parvo oftentimes will succumb to it.
He says mandating vaccines comes with a heavy price tag for pet owners.
For other vaccines, it does get to be an expense, and a lot of these vaccines are based on animals' risk.
It's a price Dame says is worth it, especially considering the potential cost if a dog goes unvaccinated.
They become my family. I almost cried. I don't know why.
As we told you at 5, the state has issued 3 violations and 1 non-renewal of a kennel license. For the Target 12 investigators, I'm Sarah Grinnelli, 12 News.